You're probably wondering how I'm able to move and talk like this. Come over here, let me explain. AI avatars are sweeping the YouTube world. And now, I'm going to show you exactly how to create one, from head to toe. Lip syncing, facial expressions, and all, right from your phone. This is a two-part video where I'll break everything down step by step so you can easily follow along. And trust me, your channel will benefit big time from this. So first we're coming over to ChatGPT. This is where we're going to create our AI avatar. And you can use the free account. So what you're looking for is consistent character. So you're gonna explore the products and in the search bar, you're gonna put in consistent character. Soon as you put that, it should pop up. It's right there. Click consistent character. And what's great about this is that it's made with DALL-E images. You're going to click where it says click here. Now it's going to ask you, do you want a male or female? We're going to choose female. Remember, this is your creative process, but I'm going to choose female. Now it's going to say, I need a name. I'm going to choose Lola because I like the name. And then it's going to ask for some characteristics. I put in black girl, mid-30s, 3D style, red long, curly afro hair, shoulder length. She's wearing glasses, dimples, boho looking clothing. This is what they come up with. I think she's adorable, but now we need a background. So you're going to go back down to search and you're going to put in, I want her sitting at a desk in her well-lit bedroom. Then you're going to click send. Now it's going to give you a photo of her. I love it right off the bat. Now you can choose to regenerate her, but I like her. So what I'm going to do is click her picture and then I'm going to click save. Now it's saved in my phone, but we need it to be 16:9. So we're going to go over to Canva. Canva is going to help us make this image 16:9. I have a 16:9 canvas and now I'm going to go to camera roll. I upload my photo and I'm going to stretch it out on the canvas as far as it can go. Now you're going to click the picture and you're going to go down to the bottom and you're going to click Magic Studio. Now you're going to slide all the way to the back where it says Magic Expand. And then you're going to click whole page. Click Magic Expand. And now it's going to expand the picture for you. Now there's four generations you can choose from or you can regenerate. I don't really like these. I think I'm going to regenerate. So what you're going to do is go to the bottom and click generate again. And these are what comes up. These ones look a lot better. The best thing about Canva is that you can regenerate as many times as you want to get your perfect expand picture. But I think I'm going to go with this one here because there's nothing on the table. Don't worry, we're going to add stuff later. So I'm going to click this one. And now what you're going to do is go to the bottom and you're going to click elements. Once you have elements up, you're going to add stuff to your picture. So maybe like a lamp. I'm going to put in lamp. There's tons to choose from. I'm going to choose this one right here. I'm going to shrink it down and put it off to this side. This is how I make my avatar, why she has a laptop and stuff in her office. So I'm going to put in plant. So let's take away the lamp and put the plant in. So let's shrink it down, put it here on the side. That looks perfect. So now we're going to put in the back of a laptop. Once you have that, you have so many to choose from, but we're going to choose this one. You know how it's off to the side because we do want to see her hands because she's going to be gesturing with them. So you're going to make it big enough to just fit right on the side so you can still see her hand, and that's it. Then you can download it. If you want her laptop more in front of her and different elements on her desk, you can delete that stuff and go back to elements. You could put in books. So now we have a stack of books and put those right on the side, shrink them down. Perfect. And maybe you want to put a different lamp. So there's tons to choose from. I'm going to choose this one and shrink it down. Now, if you want the lamp to have some sort of shadow so it looks like it's sitting on there, you're going to click the lamp and you're going to slide over down at the bottom and click effects. Then you click shadows. And then you slide all the way to the back and you're going to click on backdrop. Now it shows that it has like a shadow, so it looks more realistic sitting on the desk. Now you can make the blur amount a bit more, take down the intensity. It's your decision. But then you just set it right on the desk, just like that. And then her wall looks kind of bare back there. So let's go to elements and look for a clock. So this one looks pretty good. Let's shrink it down, put it on the back wall. Going to click the clock. And then you're going to go to the bottom and click on effects. Now you're going to click blur and you're going to click whole image. Now you're going to take the intensity up a bit so it blends in with the back. See, doesn't that look great? Okay, now let's give her a laptop in front of her. So you're going to click elements and you're going to put in back of a laptop. Now you're going to click a laptop that's to your liking. I like this one, but it has background. So you're going to put in remove background. Perfect. Shrink it down a bit and put it right in front of her, but not make it small so that you could still see her face. Now you could put your logo on the back of that laptop if you like, or you can leave it the way it is. So I think this looks really good, but I do like the other creation I made. So I'm going to keep it like this because I do want to see her hands. Now I'm going to download this image. There's also a free way to do this over on Bing Image Creator, because sometimes when you want to regenerate on ChatGPT, you can't because there is a limit. But if you come over here to Image Creator for Bing, you will be able to do it as many times as you want. If you come over to ChatGPT and put in, can you describe her for a prompt? It will give you a prompt and you can take it back over to Bing. So you're going to copy the prompt and then you're going to take it back over to Image Creator on Bing. So then you're going to put it in and you're going to click create. These are the images they came up with. Aren't these beautiful? So let's click one of these images. Now you can download it or you can resize it. Click the three little lines and then it will say resize. Then you're going to click landscape. And this is the result. She looks great the way she is, but you can add all that stuff on Canva like we did with the last image if you like. So we do want one with her hand showing, so let's regenerate again, and maybe we can get one. As you can see down at the bottom, I use this a lot. So these are the images, and a couple of them do show her hands. Sometimes she does look a little botched, like it won't show her hand, or the eye is weird. So you can generate as many times as you want. That's why I really like this image generator. So I created a list of prompts I use to make my avatar move, which I'm going to use in the video. These are so good that I've used these myself.
That's it for now. In the next video, we'll dive into creating movements, lip syncing, removing the watermark, and more.
If you enjoy learning about AI and how to use it on your phone, don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that bell button so you can get all the new updates. Thanks for watching.